Adult and Teen Challenge Society of British Columbia announced their expansion, allowing 4 more men into their program.
We currently have 8 staff members, as well as 18 students, and with 4 more, that will bring us up to 30. It's very important. Right now, we have lots of applications. Most treatment centers within the region are overwhelmed with applicants into their programs. We know there's a crisis going on.
On August 21st, 2011, Ryan died alone in his bed of respiratory failure due to a combined drug overdose. I found him the following day. Tyler did not cope well with Ryan's death. Shortly after, Tyler's drug abuse escalated to heroin. Once again, I was launched into the search for resources. We spoke to physicians, psychiatrists, counselors, outreach workers, RCMP, treatment centers, members of the clergy. January 14th, 2016, Tyler died of a pure fentanyl disguised as heroin overdose. I try and make myself believe that Ryan did come that day to guide his brother to a safer, happier place. I'm often asked, how do you do it? How do you keep going, keep advocating? I do it for Ryan. I do it for Tyler. These were my children. But believe me when I say it could be anyone's child.
It's encouraging. I myself, going through addiction, really struggled, and without a place like Teen Challenge, I don't know where I would be today. And to give that opportunity to 4 more men is absolutely incredible.
For Castnet News, I'm Alanna Kelly in Lake Country.
Read letters to the editor in our letters section under the opinion button in the yellow masthead. Email your letters to letters@castanet.net.